Morning students, today we are going to start with Act 1, Scene 3, alright, we had finished with Act 1, Scene 2 in the last class. Today we are going to start with Scene 3, again we come back to Venice, alright, if you remember, we had seen that Bassanio was in need of money, but Antonio did not have money with him at the present moment. But he promised Bassanio that somehow he will be helping Bassanio, all right? So they decide that they will go out in the street of Venice and see in what way can Antonio help Bassanio, all right? So here in scene 3, we will be introduced to one of the most important character in The Merchant of Venice, whose name is Shylock. Okay, so he is one of the most important character in The Merchant of Venice, though the play The Merchant of Venice is is named after Antonio, who is a rich merchant of Venice, but then we find Shylock has a very significant role to play in The Merchant of Venice. Okay, so though we don't have many physical appearance of Shylock in the play, but then his role is of a great importance. Now here we will be introduced to Shylock, alright. Though Shylock is termed as a villain in The Merchant of Venice, but then you see that when you will yourself will be going through the play, you can analyze his character and you can see whether he can be truly termed as a villain, all right? Is he really a villain or is he a victim, all right? Is he a victim of circumstances? You will be a better judge, all right? So let us start with scene 3, which is again set in the street of Venice. As I told you, here we will be meeting Shylock, one of the most important character in The Merchant of Venice. Shylock is a Jew, all right? He is a Jew, and one most important thing, he is a moneylender by profession, okay? So he is a moneylender, all right? And he lends out money, all right? Now, let us start with this scene. Scene 3, a street in Venice in front of Shylock's house. So this stage is there, and then we find that we understand that the stage is of the setting is of a street, all right, in Venice, and the scene takes place in front of the house of Shylock. Enter Bassanio and Shylock. So they enter on the stage. Says 3,000 ducats. Well, so you know, like there's a conversation going on between Shylock and Bassanio. Shylock is talking to Bassanio, and Shylock is telling, okay, you are in need of 3,000 ducats. Am I right? Okay, so we see that Bassanio had actually come to Shylock in order to ask for that 3,000 ducats which he wanted to go to Belmont to marry Portia. So 3,000 ducats. Ducats is a Venetian gold coin. Well, Bassanio says, "Hey, sir, yes, sir, for 3 months." So Bassanio says, "Yes, I need 3,000 ducats for 3 months." Shylock, for 3 months? Well, Bassanio, for the which, as I told you, Antonio shall be bound. So for this 3,000, there has to be some security, there has to be some there has to be some guarantee. Okay, so here Antonio will be acting as a guarantee, and Shylock will be lending 3,000 ducats, which Bassanio has to return after 3 months, and for this Antonio will be the security. Shylock says, "Antonio shall become bound." Well, Bassanio says, "May you steed me? May you steed me? Will you help me? Will you pleasure me? Will you pleasure me means, will you oblige me? Will you do me this favor? Shall I know your answer? Can you tell me the answer? That means whether you are willing to give me 3,000 ducats or not. May I know your answer?" At this, Shylock says, 3,000 ducats for 3 months and Antonio bound. Bassanio So since Shylock is repeating again and again, so it seems Bassanio is getting irritated, and Bassanio is telling, please tell me the answer. Are you ready to help me or not? Shylock says, Antonio is a good man. Now this word good has got double meaning. The word good has got double meaning. Good may refer to, it may refer to somebody's financial position, or it may refer to somebody's character. Okay, good can be in reference to financial position or a person's character. So when Shylock says Antonio is a good man, okay, Bassanio thinks that Shylock is talking about the character of Antonio, and he gets angry. All right, but then we see that Shylock was actually talking about the financial position or the wealth of Antonio. So when Shylock says Antonio is a good man, actually he was meaning that Antonio is a wealthy man. So I should not have any problem in keeping Antonio as a security in case if, you know, you are not able to return back that 3,000 ducats. Okay, so but then Bassanio, he understands this meaning of good as referring to the character of Antonio, and he gets irritated or angry, and he says, Bassanio says, have you heard any imputation? Imputation is allegation to the contrary, means have you heard anything bad about Antonio? Why are you saying that Antonio is a good man? Have you heard anything bad about his character? Shylock says, oh no, no, no. My meaning in saying he is a good man is to have you understand me that he is sufficient. So Shylock provides an explanation, and he says, Bassanio, you are getting me wrong. Actually, what I am trying to say by saying Antonio is a good man is that Antonio is sufficient. Sufficient means wealthy. All right. All right. Yet his means are in supposition. Yet his means are in supposition. Means supposition means subject to risk. Means refers to his business ventures. All right. So his business ventures are at risk. It is possible, isn't it? It is possible that you know, his ships might never come back, isn't it? It is possible that he will not be able to return back that 3,000 ducats. Who knows, isn't it? And then he provides an explanation, and he says, yet his means are in supposition. He hath an argosy. Argosy is a ship bound to Tripolis. Tripolis is actually, it's on the Mediterranean coast of, it's in the Mediterranean coast of a great, it's a great channel of trade to Central Africa. Okay, so so he says that I understand another to the Indus, I understand moreover upon the Rialto. Rialto is a stock exchange where the merchants, they meet. Okay, moreover upon the Rialto, he had a third at Mexico. So Shylock is referring to the ships of Antonio, which is which has gone to different parts. All right, some is in Tripolis, some in Indus, some in Rialto, some in Mexico, a fourth for England. And other ventures, ventures refers to his business investments, he had squandered abroad. So Shylock says, I know that Antonio's ship has gone to different parts of the world. All right, it is squandered everywhere. It has gone everywhere for its business ventures. And then he says, but ships are but boats, sailors but men. So ships, what are ships? Ships are just planks of wood. Anything can happen to the ship. It might get destroyed because of storm and so many other things. So ships are but boats and sailors but men. So sailors, they are mortal men. Anything can happen to them. They may die, and all his ships might get lost in the sea. All right. So how can I even trust Antonio? So he's analyzing, right? So then he says, but ships are but boats, sailors but men. There may be land rats, and water rats. All right, there may be land robbers, there may be sea robbers, water thieves and land thieves. I mean pirates. Pirates refers to the sea robbers. And then there's the peril of waters. Peril of water means dangers of waters, like there may be storm, there may be there might be icebergs, there might be rocks, there can be so many calamities falling on the ships of Antonio. Winds and rocks. Then he says the man, he's referring to Antonio, is notwithstanding sufficient. So he says, ultimately he says, the man is notwithstanding. Notwithstanding means nevertheless, in spite of all this, all right, considering all these things, I think this man is sufficient enough to act as a guarantee, to be the security. Okay, so the man is notwithstanding sufficient. 3,000 ducats, I think I may take his bond. So he says, I think I may safely accept him as a security. Though there may be so many calamities, though so many things can happen to his ship, there might be dangers of water, you know, there can be sea robbers, there can be land robbers, yet keeping everything in mind, I think I should accept your proposal and keep Antonio as a security. Bassanio says, be assured you may. So he says, you may rest assured that you may keep Antonio as a security because he is a very reliable person. Shylock says, I will be assured I may. So he says, first I should like to be convinced. I should like to convince myself that I should accept him as a security. I will be assured I may, and that I may be assured I will be think me. So he says, and in order to be convinced, I will have to think over. So he says, I should think whether I should keep Antonio as a security or not. First, I have to be convinced. And he says, for this, may I speak with Antonio? So Shylock says, can I have a talk with Antonio? Bassanio says, fine, if it please you to dine with us. So here, Bassanio calls for, you know, invites Shylock to have dinner with them. Now, as I told you, you have to remember that Shylock is a Jew, all right? And Antonio and Bassanio, they were Christians, all right? So, you know, these Christians, they eat pork, whereas the Jews, they don't, all right? Now, what is the reply of Shylock? Let us see. Shylock says he gets angry when Bassanio calls him for dinner. All right, he says, yes, you're calling me for dinner. Yes, to smell pork, to eat of the habitation which your prophet the Nazareth conjured the devil into. So there's a reference, there's a biblical reference where it was said that Jesus, all right, Jesus, who is the resident of Nazareth, all right, had cured a madman by ordering the devils that had possessed him, that had possessed that madman. He had ordered those devils which had possessed the madman to leave the body of that man and enter into the body of a swine, that is pigs. All right, so from that day onwards, these pigs were hated by the Jews. All right, so here he says, yes, to smell pork, to eat of the habitation. Habitation refers to the flesh of swine, which is never taken by the Jews, all right, which your prophet, the Nazareth. Nazareth refers to the Jesus, resident of Nazareth, conjured the devils into. So he says, Jesus had ordered the devils which possessed the body of the madman to enter into the body of a swine. And now you are calling me to have dinner with you, to have the flesh of that same swine, which is hated by us. It's a kind of a devil. I will buy with you, sell with you, talk with you, walk with you, and so following, but I will not eat with you, drink with you, nor pray with you. So Shylock says that I'm going to do everything with you, I'm going to talk with you, I'm going to do business with you, I'm going to walk with you, but I am never going to eat with you, drink with you, or pray with you, because our religion is different. And then he speaks out aloud, all right, he shouts and said, what news on the Rialto? What news on the Rialto? What is the news on the stock exchange? Who is he who comes here? And then he can see someone is approaching, all right, somebody is coming. Now who enters the stage now? We find Antonio entering the stage. Now we have three characters on the stage, Bassanio, Shylock, and Antonio. Now Bassanio introduces Shylock, introduces Antonio to Shylock, and then he says, Bassanio says, this is Signor Antonio. And then we find Shylock, just see within bracket, it's written aside. Aside means Shylock, when I was doing in the very beginning, when I started with Merchant of Venice, I told you the importance of aside, okay? It's a dramatic technique which is being employed by the dramatist, all right? Where the character goes to one corner of the stage and speaks out his mind aloud. Okay, so here Shylock, he goes to one, there are other characters on the stage. We have Bassanio and we have Antonio, right? But then this character, that is Shylock, he goes to one corner of the stage and he speaks out his mind, okay? And he is, it is meant for the audience, all right? Whatever he says is meant for the audience, all right? So he is speaking out his mind so that the audience comes to know what is going on in the mind of Shylock. Whereas there are other characters on the stage, they don't hear or they pretend not to hear what Shylock is saying. So Bassanio and Antonio, they do not hear what Shylock is saying. Shylock is speaking out his mind aloud, meant for the audience to know what is going on in the mind of Shylock. So Shylock goes to one side of the stage, okay, and then he says how like a fawning publican he looks. So he makes fun of Antonio and he says, look at him, look at this man. He is like a servile tax collector. Look at him. So he is criticizing Antonio, not meant for Antonio. Antonio is not listening what Shylock is saying. It is just meant, this you have to understand, this is just meant for the audience to know what is going on in the mind of Shylock, okay? And the characters, other characters are there on the stage, but they are not listening to what Shylock is saying. And then he says how like a fawning publican he looks. I hate him for he is a Christian. So this, whatever Shylock says, through this we come to know about his, why does he hate Antonio so much. We know that Shylock doesn't like Antonio and Antonio doesn't like Shylock. So truth hit this week we'll come to know as to why Shylock hated Antonio so much. What was the reason behind his hatred for Antonio? So the first reason he gives out, he says, I hate this man, I hate Antonio because he is a Christian. Okay, so we stop here. We are going to continue in the next class.